We've been working with HBO, and it's always a pleasure. I can't tell you how important it is to us to be able to do that. And now I'm going to bring up an old friend. Long, long ago, Rolando Arellano was the manager of Fernando Vargas. As part of that journey on HBO, he must have fought, I can't, you know how many times? I don't even know.
Many, many times. I think it was 19 years old.
Yeah, and had a spectacular career there. And Rolando, as I said, was half the fun, really, of working with Fernando. And it's wonderful to have him back here today, now that he is the executive in charge of fighter relations for Golden Boy Promotions, and I'm going to bring him up to introduce Slava and tell us all about what he expects in America.
Actually, my boxing birth was given over at Main Events, and I learned so much from Kathy and from Patrick English, from Jolene and many of the other staff members. But good afternoon. My name is Rolando Arellano. On behalf of Oscar De La Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions and all the staff members, it's a great pleasure to be here. We thank all of you for joining us today. It's also an absolute pleasure to be working with my dear friends again over at Main Events, of course HBO, and the one and only Madison Square Garden. As we all know, in the recent years, there has been a complete portfolio of Eastern European boxers that have taken boxing by storm. Golden Boy now has the pleasure to represent one of these boxers by the name of Slava Shabransky. The name's actually a lot bigger than that, but I'm not gonna make an attempt to, to try to ruin it out here. So, and he's actually from the Ukraine. Slava has a record of 19-1, 16 by way of knockout. He is currently the WBC, USNBC, light heavyweight champion of the world. It is my pleasure, ladies and gentlemen, at this point in time to introduce the champ, Slava Shabransky.
Good afternoon. It's a great pleasure to be in New York. I'm excited to be fighting at Madison Square Garden on HBO. I'm excited to be fighting a great ex-world champion, Sergey Kovalev. I look forward to bring the best in me for this fight, the only thing. Thank you. See you November 25th.
They just weren't available, but when we pulled Golden Boy, we had an answer in about an hour, and that speaks to the professionalism of the people over at Golden Boy. It also speaks to the professionalism of this gentleman to my side, Mr. Shabransky. This is the way boxing is supposed to be. Fighters are supposed to want to fight each other, and it's refreshing when it happens. So generally, those turn out to be the best fights. And so now, I am going to introduce to you Sergey's manager. And also my friend, Mr. Agus Klimas.
A nice lady. Good afternoon, everybody. Very happy to be back here in New York City, Madison Square Garden. As far as November 30th career, we never fought here in New York, so we would be very excited. We have a lot of fans, a lot of people that will fight somewhere else, New York Las Vegas or Los Angeles. So many people are coming from New York. Now we're going to be able to bring Sergey's fight to New York, so we're going to have a lot of fans. As far as I know, it's a lot of Ukrainian fans here in New York. So hopefully that Madison Square Garden Theater is gonna be sold out. But we'd like to thank HBO for giving us this opportunity. Special thanks to my fighter, Sergey Kovalev, coming back, being after all those nonsense things. So he's a, I feel like, I believe he's a clear-headed, completely clear-minded, coming for the next fight. As far as Slava, I know Slava already also for some time. He was coming to my gym, sparring with, never sparred Sergey, but he was sparring with some other my fighters. The one thing he has for sure, that's his nickname, Lionheart. He has a heart, so I know that fight is gonna be a really good fight for both of the guys, and I just wanted to wish good luck to both of them.
Thank you, Angus. A man who I had the pleasure of introducing many, many times, and every time I get a thrill. He is the former unified light heavyweight champ of the world, and I think he's going to be that again sooner than perhaps we thought. And this is the next step on the road to achieve that goal. And so here he is, Sergey Kovalev.
Hi everybody, I'm very happy to be here in New York. First time, my fight coming up November 25th, and I'm really happy to fight on this post again, but I fought in New Jersey, Atlantic City, but never fought in New York. And I want to say thank to my team, and promoter Katie Duo, and my manager, HBO, and also to team Slava Shabransky, and personally to Slava Shabransky that he approved the fight, fight me November 25th. I will back stronger than I was before. It's my goal right now to improve everybody and for myself that I still fighter, I still strong fighter, and I can be world champion again. And that I have two last losses, it's just like a huge lesson for me. Not like a bug for the bunch, like a just in my life, you know. I mean, I made a lot of analysis, you know, from these losses, and I hope I will be much stronger than I was before. Thank you very much for your support, and see you in November. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sergey. One little plug I want to put in. We have a nice little show coming up on October 5th up in Mohegan Sun. It's another main events, Mohegan Sun Rising Star Show, and if you can make it out, you should come. It's a beautiful card with Juan Alexander fighting Elvin Ayala in the main event. It's going to be tremendous. And I guess to close, I just want to say again, thank you to the beautiful Renaissance. Thank you to Madison Square Garden. Oh, you want to do the questions? Oh.
I have a couple questions from the media that are watching. So
oh, okay.
Maybe
sorry.
Sergey, maybe you could go up to the podium to answer them.
Sure, Sergey.
There's some guys watching on the live stream. Tim Dahlberg from AP would like to know your reaction to the announcement of Andre Ward's retirement.
If it's 100% true, that it's good for the boxing. You know, because it's good for the boxing. We're ready to fight again, you know, like for these titles, and makes interesting fights between great fighters, you know. And right now in our division, a lot of good and strong fighters who wants to get these titles, you know. And this will be very, very good, good fight for the boxing fans.
Backing up on that, Ron Borges wants to know if you think his retirement is real or it's for publicity.
Minor that?
No, his, Andre's retirement.
I don't know. I don't think about him at all, you know, because I'm looking forward and get my goals, you know. What was with my last two fights? It's already history, you know. I forgot about this.
Are you disappointed of the possibility that you would not get a third fight?
Yes and no, you know, like if this fight can happen like very quickly, I'm happy. If like long time waiting and like just the fighting close to titles, it's not good, you know. Like just like I wanna be best, you know, in this division, and I wanna to fight with the best fighters in this division, you know.
And Mike Woods from Ring would like to know if you have an update on your trainer search.
You know, like I'm not looking for a coach. It's just like everything comes as comes, you know, like just have a patience. Have a patience. We'll be, my team will be completely in my training camp and in the ring also.
When do you begin training?
When? Next Monday.
Do you go to Big Bear first, like you've been doing?
I didn't resolve, you know, like, yes and no, again, like, just it depends from the weather. From the weather in Big Bear.
It's probably pretty nice there now. All right, thanks. That's all I have from him.
Okay, thank you.
If any questions from in the house?
Yeah, chill and feel with me. Maybe somebody again.
Jose Batista of Boxing View. I would like to know if you find the timing of Andre Ward's retirement strange. If he trying to upstage you?
Yeah, you know, like they, his team and his self, like, can play, you know, with like mentally games as they did before second rematch, before rematch, you know, like, I don't know, I don't care at all.
Antonio Baez, AB Boxing News. You said that you are starting next week at Big Bear. Is there a possibility that you work with Abel Sanchez?
No.
Okay. Anybody else?
Yeah, right here behind you.
Destino Lewis, Black Star News. Supposedly, Andre Ward left those titles vacant, and of course, everybody's looking at those vacant titles. But if you don't reach that goal, would you go after Superman Stevens?
Right back here.
I'm really fighting anybody, you know, like, but my goal to fight for the title, like, close, like, as soon as possible, you know. But like right now, my fight against Slava Shabransky, and I have a focus on this fight right now. After this fight, will be understanding for me next week.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Hey, Sergey, the Emilio ES News. A while back, it was kind of a foreign publication, so I'm not sure how much truth there is into it. But Virgil Hunter had reached out, I think. And you kind of humored the idea of having him as your trainer if Andre was to move to cruiserweight or, i.e., retire. Is that still a possibility to have Virgil Hunter be your new trainer? If somebody wants to translate that.
I thought about the but didn't decide it at all. I'm still thinking, but it's a good offer, you know, maybe not, you know, just. I can't get back to my
to gym of my opponent, who ahead, you know, and like, you know, like it is right now 2 person inside me like wrestling, like
okay,
yes or no, you know, it's like it's not easy to say yes or no, but just keep going myself right now, and I already almost understand who will be in my team, but I'm not already announced it, you know, like just because I'm not sure 100% ready today or not. Just, but I already decided
okay.
Who I want to see in my training camp, in my team, you know.
Thank you.
Sergey, stopping there with AB Boxing News. Would this matchup with Chabrowski determine if you stay at light heavyweight or move up to cruiserweight after this matchup?
Cruiserweight, very good because you can eat more, like not keep diet. But I understand right now that I'm small for cruiserweight. You know, guys losing weight like from the over 200 pounds. You know, and in the fight they can have a weight like 210, 215 and more pounds. You know, like, but I'm 185, 190 maximum, you know, like it's difficult to make 175 for one day, you know, but after this, my weight, I get the weight back and I feel good, you know, just, I think so now. Maybe in future we'll try, but not right now.
I think that's all we have, unless anybody else has one.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sergey. Don't stand up in the middle, please. Where they can come out in front. Just throwing out the options. And I can't get a picture of the guy back of that guy's head, so I do need him down. Got to get your head down. Thanks.
That's the